My boyfriend Charlie's coming to meet me today to ask me what I think he's going to ask me. He asked me to meet him here today, so we'll see. Hey, Charlie! Hey, Charlie! You want to know what I did today? I went shopping. I looked at bedroom sets, and I looked at kitchen sets and dining sets. And bedroom sets. Oh, look, I got my money right here. My whole dowry. Oh, Charlie. Isn't the lake so beautiful? Oh, I feel so nice. Shall we throw something in the lake for good luck?
Jesus Christ. All right, I'm going to have to write you up. There's no swimming in the pot. What's your name?
Charity Hope Valentine.
Occupation?
I'm a social consultant.
Where at?
The Fandango Ballroom.
And Saul hostess.
No, it's just temporary.
Length of employment?
8 years.
All right.
Go get yourself dry. Stay out of trouble. Let's take this with you. So, Fandango Ballroom, maybe I'll come by for a dance later.
Up yours! Mister, can I talk to you for a minute?
Hey, buddy, got a cigarette for me?
Hey, mister, you speak French? Come here, I want to talk to you.
Hey, cowboy, you want a tango? Takes two to tango.
Oh, you're so tall.
Hey,
boy, let's have some fun.
The minute you walked in the joint, I could see you were a man of distinction, a real big spender, good looking, so refined. Say, would you like to know what's going on in my mind? So let me get right to the point. I don't pop my cork for every guy I see. How's about a few laughs? I can show you a good time. Do you wanna have fun? Fun, fun. How's about a few fun laughs? Fun, laughs, fun, laughs, good laughs, fun, laughs, good time. Fun, laughs, good time. Fun, laughs, good time.
Let me show you
good time. Hey, big spender. Hey, big. The minute you walked in the joint, I can see you were a man of distinction, a real big spender. Good looking, so refined. So don't you like to know what's going on in my mind? So let me get right to the point. I don't pop my quote for every guy I see. Hey, big spender! Hey, big spender! Hey, big spender! Spend a little time with me. How's about it, Palsy? Girls, in addition to stinking business, now we have a new, young, good-looking chick, which we need like Idaho needs potatoes.
Hello, I'm Rosie.
Not for long, you ain't.
So this is the ballroom.
Yeah, the ballroom. This is where you're going to meet Prince Charming, who's going to whisk you away on his white horse to Scarsdale. You should live so long.
It's awfully dark in here, don't you think?
Oh, it's called merchandising. If the goods are a little short, worry you don't put them in the window. Honey, you got nothing to worry about. You're worth $6.50 a half hour.
Is that what they pay to dance with us?
Uh-huh.
Which you just split with the owner.
Every penny of which you will earn. You dance a little, talk a little, bet your eyes a little, shake your hips a little, and like this, you kill a lifetime.
Oh, I was about to say.
Sure.
My boyfriend's in California, and once I save up enough money here, we're gonna get married.
Oh, you'll make a sweet old couple.
Honey, take it from me. You want a piece of advice? Get out while you still can before you wind up like the rest of us.
Oh, don't you look at me. I was always like this.
Oh, that's my girl.
What do I do?
Honey, from here on out, it's every man for himself. Baby, you from Brooklyn,
you're looking like a dancer.
You know what? I think you left something out of that story.
Like what?
Like there ain't a word of truth in that.
Hello, man.
Hello. Nikki.
Did you hear about Kat and her boyfriend?
Oh, he proposed.
Oh, he stole her money and pushed her in the lake.
Honey, he wasn't for you.
Hey, Prince Philip just walked in the door.
Oh,
see, come on, you know, stick your gun behind your ears and drag it on the floor. Let's go, come on.
He's out there. I know he is, with a perfectly logical explanation.
Honey, listen to me. You know that I, Nikki Pignatelli, does not like to say harsh or cruel things about anybody. Despite the fact that I may have spent a few quiet years in an upstate government hotel, I am basically kind, warm, and sincere, true. So as your friend, as someone who loves and cares for you, I feel I owe you this. You're a stupid broad. Your problem is you run your heart like a hotel. You're always letting guys check in and out whenever they want.
It's different. I did slip. He wouldn't push me. In fact, I'll bet you he's out there waiting for me like he's been out there every night for the past 2 months. I know he won't be here tonight. I know it. He will be here tonight. He will be here.
He won't be here.
I know he won't be here.
honey. If he stole your purse, why didn't you call the cops? Maybe they could still pick him up.
Man, you know how many guys there with pocketbooks in New York City?
Nikki, and the things I used to do for him. Waking up in the middle of the night to get him a provolone sandwich and a bottle of Yoo-hoo chocolate milk.
Men, they got no feelings.
Oh, honey, forget him. Come on, we got a living to make. If you call this a living.
You should see yourself like tonight. You're 100 watts electric lights. You're a blockbuster buster, you got class. And when you make a pass, man, it's a pass.
Ursula! Ursula!
I gave you taxi right away, I'm going home!
Ursula, wait a minute!
Taxi!
Signora, please. Excuse me. Ursula.
That's the movie star, that's Vittorio Vidal!
Amore, I only said hello to the girl, that's all!
Look, that's really him!
Don't touch me, Vittorio, you're through! I hate you, do you? I hate the sight of you!
She really
you can't just walk out like this on me.
I can't. Just watch me.
Watch, you know, watch.
Okay. Now, Ursula, how would it look for a big movie star like me to be in a club without a girl?
That's your problem.
You're not walking out on me. You're coming inside.
No, I am not.
Ursula, you're coming back inside.
No, I am not, you stupid, deep picture fan, Romeo. You want to go back in there and get yourself another girl.
Ursula. You, are you busy tonight?
Hey, what's your name? You're busy tonight?
No, you. Yes. You, are you busy tonight?
Vittorio, you wouldn't dare, a girl of the streets.
Oh, wouldn't I?
Come. Vittorio, you wouldn't dare.
Up with him.
Thank you.
I just wish I knew what she wanted, you know? Sometimes I look at a girl, she goes insane. Wouldn't you call this psychotic? I mean, she's so demon, so full of life, so passionate, you know? I mean, I don't know why women are like this. Have you ever met a man you couldn't depend on?
I depend on them all the time.
Well, I have the feeling I only spoke about myself. It must be so boring.
Well, I wouldn't want you to be bored. Talk about something else.
I don't want to talk anymore.
What do you want to do?
I want to dance.
Ow! Oh, sorry! Oh, I just feel a little woozy. I haven't had anything to eat but candy this morning. Do you mind putting out your arms, please?
Why?
Because I'm going to faint.
Somebody get some ammonia!
Wrap her wrist.
Lose up, hold on.
Give us some air.
Here, somewhere.
Where?
Your apartment.
You know, I just realized I don't know anything about you.
Oh, well, I can tell you everything about me. What I do, and who I am, but then it would be a waste of time because I'm going to lie.
Why? Why would you lie?
Because I want to impress you, and if I told you what I really did, you wouldn't be very impressed.
Let me be the judge of it. What is it you do?
Well... I'm a dance hall hostess.
Okay.
You see, you should have let me lie. I was gonna be an assistant dental technician.
But that doesn't sound very impressive.
It is to a dance hall hostess.
Well, it doesn't seem to be impressive for you. Why would you choose a job if it dissatisfies you?
I don't know. Fickle finger fate, I guess.
What?
Fickle finger fate. You don't know what it means?
I guess so.
Well, so many things seem to happen to me, you know? And I never know why or how. And people are always asking me, why did you put up with the guy? Or how did you wind up in that joint? And I got so embarrassed saying I don't know. Mm-hmm. But it's the truth, I don't. But I guess you're supposed to know why or how you do things, you know? But I guess, you know. Anyways, now when people ask me why or how, I just say fickle finger fate, and I don't get as embarrassed.
I think you just like saying it.
I think so. Fickle finger bait. It comes about. You wanna try it?
Yes. The fickle, the finger, the fate.
You like it?
It's wonderful. To us. Bottoms up.
Up yours. Sorry, it slipped.
Charity, you're wonderful. Really. Really wonderful.
Me wonderful? Woo! That's something coming from Victoria Vidal.
Charity, what makes you think that Victoria Vidal is so special?
Are you kidding me? Have you seen you in the movies?
Not recently.
Well, you don't know what you're missing. There was this one movie that you did with Monica Montcelli. And there was this one scene where you took her into your arms. You gave her this wild, passionate kiss. And she started to cry like this. Oh, Mario! Mario! And you remember what you did?
Fortunately, no.
You said, as long as I live. And then you bent down, and you kissed every one of her fingers. From her pinky to her thumb. And then you said, and I remember every word exactly, you said, without love, life has no purpose. Did that hit home? You got me right where I live. I watched the whole picture in 6 Milky Ways just to hear that line. Without love, life has no purpose.
And is that what you believe?
Yeah. Don't you? Doesn't everybody?
But why do you believe in love?
Well, I guess we're supposed to have some religion.
So, love is your religion.
Well, I'll tell you one thing. I do go to church a lot.
Charity. You're sitting here in front of me, and with my own eyes, I cannot believe that you're really here and I see you.
I don't believe I'm here either.
Huh?
Say, do you think I can have a personally autographed picture?
Of course.
You know, just to prove it to myself.
Of course, of course. With mustache or without?
Without.
Without, okay. And it's for?
Charity.
For charity.
Who was in my apartment tonight alone?
Alone.
I swear.
I swear.
Victoria?
I know the rest. Eccola.
Thank you. Ooh, you're moving in my locker tomorrow night. Oh, what a night for me. Say, I don't think this is gonna be enough though.
Enough for what?
To prove to my girls that I was really here. Say, do you think I could have a small article of personal apparel? Say like a handkerchief or a tie? Or, you know, an old coat? Something? Anything?
There's something. You won't leave, will you?
Oh, I won't leave. Hurricane Hazel could strike and I'm not moving.
Charity! I used this in $1 million leaves.
It's a beautiful black thing.
It's a hat! Eccola!
Eccola!
There's more!
Eccola! Oh, the girls in the ballroom would never believe me in a million years! If they could see me now, that little gang of mine, I'm eating fancy chow and drinking fancy wine. I like the stumble ones to see where I'm back. The kind of top grows first rate, jumps I attract. All I can say is, well, you look at where I am. Now I landed, out right in a pile of jam. But if they're from honey cow, they never leave it in my friends could see me now.
I use this in the dancing spa. It's yours.
Oh, no. I couldn't.
You must.
Oh, no, I can't.
Charity, I insist.
Okay, I'll take it.
There's more.
Goodbye, Victoria, baby.
I find I have nothing in my possession that truly expresses my feelings for you. So please, I want to ask you to accept this.
Oh, I accept! And I must say that I've never, ever, ever received a gift that came in a gorgeous package. Oh my God. Okay. Thank you! Good.
keep smoking those funny little cigarettes, you're bound to do a little flying.
You don't believe me? You don't believe I spent the night with Victoria Vida?
Do you swear?
I swear.
On your mother's life?
On my mother's life.
Call up and find out how her mother is doing.
Begin to these. They're mementos of our evening together.
That's
his hat and his cane.
That's all he gave you? Honey, if I were you, I would pass the hat and beat myself to death with that cane because you are dumb.
But you don't know what happened.
Forget it. What you do in bed is your business.
I wasn't in bed. I was on the bar stool.
To each his own. Oh, you could have had a mink coat.
Why would he give me a mink coat?
If you're messing with the fucking details, you're bound to do never gonna get anywhere.
A hat and a cane. If it were me, I would have walked out of there with my own beauty parlor. Baby, you are stuck. Just like the rest of us.
But there ain't no use flapping your wings anymore because we're stuck in this flypaper of life.
You know what? Not me.
What?
I said not me. I'm not gonna spend the next 40 years in the Fandango ballroom. I'm not gonna become the world's first little old taxi dancer. I am getting out.
Out? What a beautiful woman.
There's gotta be something better than this. There's gotta be something.
Parties and water coolers, coffee breaks. When I sit at my desk on the 41st floor, in my copy of a copy of a copy of Dior, I'll receive big typhoons and I'll point to a chair. I'll say, hi, welcome, lady. I'm gonna be a hat check girl.
Ooh!
Sardis East. And I'm gonna wear one of those fine little black numbers, you know, cut up to here and down to there. And new clothes, hats coming in. Derbies, Converse. New the cute little skinny brim with the feathers. Check your hat, sir, check your coat, sir, check your vest, sir, check your pants, check your socks, sir, check your shoes, sir. I can hold them while you dance. Check your eyes, sir, check your ears, sir, check and see if you are free. How about it? After hours, I'll tell you, and you check me.
I'm getting out. Baby, what can you do?
I don't know. Just get me out. We'll figure it out later.
There's
Ladies, they have just announced the winners of the 1964 Irish Sweepstakes. And since none of you are among the winners, get your asses out there!
First of all, watch your language! And second of all, we're not so sure we're coming.
All right, well, I can always find someone else.
That's the third I'm coming, Herman! What happened to all the wonderful plans we just had? Yeah, whatever happened to them? Well, I'm not giving up without a fight, okay? I'm getting out of here. I'm gonna go to new places and meet new people. I just need a little bit of refinement and a little bit of culture.
But class started at 8 o'clock and it's already 8:15, so...
When I'm through!
When you're through, yes.
Now, at 9 o'clock, we have Dr. Cindy Greenwald. Would you be interested in the psychologist workshop?
No, I'm not very good with my hands.
I really hate to interrupt, but I'm gonna be very late.
All right!
It's gonna be very late.
Room 603.
603. Thank you. And thank you very much. Thank you. 603.
What class is that?
It's a self-analytical discussion group. People are prodded and say anything that comes into their minds under the careful supervision of a medical student. It can be very dangerous.
I think I'll take a crack at that. 603. 603. Going up?
I'm going up to 6.
Oh, likewise.
What was that?
I think we stopped. Mm-hmm. Press the button. We'll start right up again.
Something's wrong. We're stuck.
These old elevators, you can never trust them.
Oh, boy. It's getting a little stuffy in here, huh? Isn't it getting a little stuffy?
You think so?
Yeah. Would you like to try pressing one of the buttons?
Oh, I'm all right, thank you. I'm pretty sure I pressed them very well.
You're right. I pressed them very well. I gave them a very good press. So I guess we're stuck.
I guess so. This is maximum weight. 1,300.
How much do you weigh?
128.
We're fine.
Sure.
Yeah. Fine. Just stuck in the old elevator.
You all right?
Yeah, me? Fine. Fine. I just gotta get used to it. It's my first time. Trapped in an elevator. Just gotta get used to it.
You don't have claustrophobia, do you?
What? No! No! Nothing of the sort, claustrophobia! No! I just don't like being in small, tight spaces that I can't get out of. But I can handle it. Because I know that we'll be out of here in just a few minutes.
Sure we will.
You really think so?
I do. I really do.
But if you really thought that we were trapped, what would you say?
I would say we were really trapped.
Oh my God! I knew it!
We're not, you shouldn't really get so excited.
I know, this is awful. I never act like this. I'm normally a very calm person, and if it really came down to it, you could depend on me. You understand that?
Yes.
I just hope it doesn't come down to it. I realize that you suffer from claustrophobia, and I know that you are very uncomfortable, and I wouldn't want you to be in here for any longer than I have to be. Help! 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 Help!
My name is Charity Hope Valentine! You're shaking!
All over!
Let me rub your wrist, yeah?
You know what I feel like doing right now with my impulses? Taking off my clothes.
Oh, no. That wouldn't do much good, would it?
You think I would have a telephone in here? Never again will I go in an elevator without a telephone. I am always checked for a telephone.
Change subject.
Oh, if I could only get out of here for a few minutes, just a few minutes, I'd be all right. I'd go back in.
Best thing to do is, keep talking. Then you won't think about it. Your name? What's your name? Your name, you know, like... Frank! Frank, Harry, Sydney, Sydney Bruce, that's a name.
Oscar! My name is Oscar.
Oscar, your last name, Oscar?
My what?
Your last name, don't you have a last name, Oscar?
No, I don't think so.
Oscar, yes, you do. Like Oscar Mamanetti, like Oscar Greenspan, Oscar Greenspan.
Greenspan!
Okay.
No, wait. Lindquist. Oscar Lindquist. Oh!
Stop quick breathing, Oscar. Where do you live?
Ooh, what?
Where do you live?
In an elevator.
You live in an elevator.
Yes. 411 East 74th Street. I gotta stop breathing. I'm gonna use a pull the air.
No, we got plenty of air.
Oh, this is unfair. You should be breathing some of this.
No. Are you married?
What?
Do you have a wife? Are you married, Oscar? Married. Are you married, for God's sake? Are you married?
No! I'm not married. Don't leave me!
Oh, I will leave you. You're gonna be okay, because I'm gonna be here with you.
What should I do?
I'm gonna help you, okay? Just do everything I do, okay? When I was a jittery, my knees buckled, I swallowed tickles my skull. I'm trapped like a butterfly in a net. Then I say to myself, I'm the greatest thing to make.
Shimmy up the cable and then force the door open upstairs. What do you think?
I think it could work, but it sounds a little bit dangerous.
Oh, then don't try it. Stay with me. Some people simply, I can't swallow. I think I'm going to die. Sometimes, if you pardon the word, I spit.
Then you say to yourself,
I'm the bravest individual I have ever met. I'm the bravest individual. From now on, I'm gonna be all right.
Attaboy, Oscar.
What was that?
Oh, the lights went off.
Help!
Oscar! Help! Oh. Oscar! Press the button!
We're moving! Your real problem is panic. It causes a break in my heart. Anyway, I'll see you around.
Yeah. Around.
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 Around where?
I don't know. Where are you going?
Well, if you, you're not doing anything, I was wondering if you might want to come to church with me.
What denomination are you talking about?
It's the Rhythm of Life Church. It's, under the Manhattan Bridge, started out as a jazz group in San Francisco, and now it's a religion. I hear it's an emotional experience.
Well, I'm always into emotional experience.
Come on. We'll walk.
Daddy started out in San Francisco, tooting on his trumpet loud and mean.
Suddenly a voice said, "Go for it, Daddy, spread the picture on the wider screen."
And the voice said, "Daddy, there's a million pigeons waiting to be hooked on new religions. Hither, oh Daddy, you're coming my way. Spread the religion of the rhythm of life.
Eternity.
But before
all my debts, all my grievances, and my alimony. I will report each and every month to the police.
That's fine.
Finally, I will not indulge in the evil marijuana weed coming in August pot. It is harmful.
Yes.
It is sinful.
Yes.
It's very expensive.
Yes.
And I suggest you drop the goods before the cops come.
Sure, something.
When do you find places like that?
I'm on a mailing list. It's the Church of the Week group. Look, I was wondering if you would be willing to. Can I see you tomorrow night?
Well, I mean, it depends, because if we're going to do some human sacrifices.
A movie. A real movie with a happy ending.
I'm nuts about happy endings.
Great, so, how's after work at your office?
What makes you think I have an office?
It's kind of a hobby of mine. I can look at somebody and tell you exactly what they do. As a matter of fact, I know exactly what kind of office you work in. A bank.
You got it! First National Williamsburg Ranch.
I knew it. I'm a great judge of character. So, how's 6 o'clock at the bank?
Listen, I wouldn't want you to come all the way down here to Williamsburg. Besides, tomorrow we take in the inventory and count all the blotters and all the pennies and all that jazz. Suppose I meet you in front of the what?
Where?
In front of the what?
Yeah. Look, I just wanted to say, Charity, that I had a very nice time tonight. Being with you.
So did I, Oscar?
A very nice time.
That's what I had. A very nice time.
Well, good night.
Good night.
You're a lovely girl, Charity. Sweet Charity.
Good night, Oscar.
No. Is it, Helene?
What?
If a man smooches your hand, would you consider that a pass?
Well, that depends.
On what?
On where your hand is when he kisses it.
Hey, where was your hand?
At the end of my arm. He's always behaved like a perfect gentleman.
Ah, what's a perfect gentleman?
Is that my fault you never met one?
Honey, if he keeps smooching your hand, maybe he's after something.
Like what?
Your wristwatch.
The only thing he's after is inner contentment. He wants me to help him find it.
Maybe you should have picked up a few $100 words since you've been going around with this goofball.
Oscar's not a goofball, though. He's just a very complicated and highly intelligent person.
Okay. So besides slobbering all of your knuckles, what else can he do?
He's in the tax accountancy profession, and he's a graduate of the CCNYU University.
Sounds like a goofball to me. Mm.
What does that goofball think of your vocation?
My what?
Your chosen field of endeavor. I mean, does he know that you're a dance hall hostess?
Oh, he thinks nothing of it.
She ain't told him.
First of all, he is highly too educated to be bothered with things like that, okay? And second of all, he already knows because I told him.
That you're a dance hall host.
Yes! Yes!
You
I told him!
When?
Next Sunday is when I told him! Next Sunday! Come behind!
That girl just will not listen. She won't listen.
What do you think they talk about when they're alone?
Talk? She's known for everything but talking.
You're right. He probably does all the talking. Feeding her those smooth moves like, hey baby, last night I dreamed we were in a cozy little cottage covered with clinging vines.
And there we were, clinging more than the vines.
And then he converts the convertible so funny, really gets to work.
Quote.
Baby, dream your dream. Close your eyes and try it. Dream of furniture. Dream that I can buy it. That fancy bed you pray for. Not only bought but paid for. Dream or sign the lease. Leave a small deposit. We'll ask the local jet set to dine on our dinette set. Right across the street, there's a friendly thank you. Make a friendly loan. And the bank says thank you. Every Saturday, we'll spend all our money. Join the PTA.
Ready to fly the coop.
Three fat, hungry kids, all in pink condition. So who's in the red? That nice obstetrician. Big Daddy's favorite pastime. He's had it for the last time. So Daddy, don't come home. He says he's gone bowling.
If someday I could find the kind of guy who'd say to me,
baby, dream your dream. Close your eyes and try it. Dream of three fat kids. Brother, would I buy it? Peaches and cream. If only I could dream, 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 a
technicians, please report to the Ferris wheel immediately, if not sooner. Attention all Coney Island patrons. The Ferris wheel is temporarily closed due to a minor malfunction. And patrons, don't forget to try our new bubblegum flavored snow cones. Have a great day. Ta-ta.
Hey, Oscar. Don't panic. Everything's gonna be fine, Oscar. Won't do you any good to panic. You won't panic, will you?
No, I think it's a very good possibility that I won't.
Okay. You see, Oscar? It's not like the elevator. We got plenty of air here. You see all the air we got, Oscar?
You're right.
He's got enough air to last us for hours.
Yes. You see? Are you going to stay with me, Oscar, please? Please stay with me. I stayed with you in the elevator. It's only fair, okay?
I'll stay as long as you need me to.
Oh, I've never been this scared before. You see, I'm usually very calm in situations like this, Oscar.
And I'm usually very scared.
Now I'm the one who's scared.
And I'm unusually calm.
Maybe that's why I'm scared.
Because I'm calm.
Yeah. Well, you know what? You can depend on someone. Someone that can take care of you. You can afford to be scared. Oh, I've never had anyone like that.
I've never had anybody depended on me before.
Oh, Oscar, I'm depending on you.
Okay, well, let me sit back, relax, and be scared, because I am very dependable. Don't worry about the girl. I'm up here.
Oh, Oscar, you're such comfort.
I do what I can.
Hold on to me, please.
For as long as you like.
I like it for as long as we're up here.
Then I hope we never come down.
I honestly, don't know what happened to me.
It's funny. Because I know exactly what's happened to me. There was a man with no dream and no plan. Then one lonely night I found Sweet Jerry, you make life fun for me. Oh, what it's done for me having you around. Sweet Jerry, one word I never said lately pop off the top of my head. Incredible if by and by you and I should be we. I could touch the sky quite easily, so if you are free, see charity please belong to me. Sweet, sweet charity please belong to me.
Oscar? Scared is because I have to tell you something that you might not like about me.
There couldn't be anything about you that I don't like.
See, I don't exactly work at the Williamsburg branch of the First National City Bank.
Charity, ever since I met you, I knew there was something different about you. You have a quality, Charity, a quality I've never seen in a girl before.
No, I definitely do not work at the Williamsburg branch of the First National City Bank.
And you know what that quality is, Charity? It's purity. It's innocence. In you, I have found pure innocence.
You see? I don't exactly work at the Williamsburg branch of the Purity Bank.
It's the truth, Charity. You're the last of a dying breed. A virgin. Yes. A virgin. In the most poetical sense of the word.
Although we do have 37 branches throughout the city.
Warm words I've never said lately pop off the top of my head. Incredible if by and by you and I should be we. I could touch the sky quite easily, so if you are free, sweet charity, please belong to me. Sweet charity, please belong to me.
Thank you.
about?
I couldn't tell him. I couldn't tell him.
Lighten up, baby.
I'm just so sick of everything. I'm so sick of this job. I'm so sick of my life. I'm so sick of this musical snake pit.
Well, you could always go back to Mommy and Daddy's place in Southampton.
I'm getting out sooner than any of you guys think.
Hey, come on.
Look busy, baby. The boss is watching.
Let him watch. Let him fire me! You think I care? Let him fire me. I don't care.
I think you do care.
I don't care. I cared for 8 years. 8 years! But I don't care anymore. You want to know why I don't care? Because this is not a nice place. This is not a nice place. All right? I like you and I like Helene and I like the girls and I even like Herman, but I do not like it here.
What are you trying to say?
What I'm trying to say is that I made a mistake in my life and I'm getting out of here. Understand? Out. I'm getting out now. I'm getting out right now.
Do you mean to say that you're leaving, honey?
Yes!
What?
Yes! Yes, I'm leaving! You're right! You're right, I'm leaving!
You
tell me.
Cherry,
I... Sit down, Oscar, please.
Well, are you going to sit with me?
Oscar, I have to tell you something, and if I have to see you in the eyes, I don't think I'll be able to say them.
Hola, amigos. Specialo for the day is Huevos Ranchero. Are you alone, miss?
She's with me.
Oscar... I had to see you today to tell you that I can't see you anymore, Oscar.
What?
Don't look at me. Please don't look at me. Are you going to ask me why I can't see you anymore? Ask me why I can't see you anymore.
You can't see me anymore.
Never mind, I'll tell you. I can't see you anymore because we're not going anywhere, Oscar. And we're not going to get anywhere either because you don't know where I've been. Oscar, I don't, and probably never will, work in a bank.
Oh.
Oscar, and I don't even have a bank account, Oscar. I keep my money in a can of Chase Scent and Sandburn coffee.
Charity.
Hey, you want to know how I earn that money, Oscar? Do you? Huh?
You're a dance hall hostess.
I'm a dance hall hostess. I work in a dance hall, and I talk to strange men, and I drink with them, and I dance with them, and... That's right. How do you know?
I've known for about a week now. One night I was riding the bus and saw you. I jumped off. Went into this dance hall. I went inside, stood in the corner, and you were sitting in a booth with some man. You were laughing and giggling. I didn't stay long, maybe an hour. That night when I went home, I tried very, very hard to hate you, Charity. But I just couldn't. I just couldn't hate you.
Well, maybe you'll have better luck tonight. You wanna know what other business the other girls are in?
I'm not interested.
Are you going to ask me if I'm in it?
It's not important.
It's not important. Not important? Well, then it's to me, okay? Oscar. I'm in love with you, Oscar. And I'm not going to be in love with some jerk who's not interested enough to find out if I really am what I'm hinting I might be.
Charity, I don't care what you are or what you've done. All I know is that I want to marry you.
You know what? Let's settle one thing at a time, okay? Oscar, I'm not a poetical virgin.
Charity, don't cry. I believe you.
No, you believe me, Oscar. I'm crying about the other part.
What other part?
The marrying part. I didn't hear it the first time.
Marry me.
Oh, Oscar, you're not playing with me, are you? Because asking a girl to marry her is one of her most sensitive areas. You shouldn't say it unless you really mean it, Oscar. Because you can really hurt people by kidding around like that. And I don't think I can go through another injury of that nature.
Charity, for the first time in my life, I'm happy inside. Really happy. And it's all because of you.
Oh, Oscar.
Don't look at me. You can be emotional too, you know. Give me your hand. You know what we're gonna do, Charity? We're gonna get out of this city.
I like that.
Maybe get a little home in the country.
Yes, I like that.
Maybe I'll start up a gas station. I've always loved cars.
You like that.
The mobile gas franchise with a big red and white sign.
I like that.
What really matters is that we'll be together.
That's what matters, Oscar.
Forget about your past. Forget about what you've done.
Oh, I forgot.
Some men can do that, Charity, but not me.
Not you, Oscar.
Because I need you, Charity. I need you and I love you. There's this little place on Route 66 in the safe. I think that...
Somebody loves me!
Seven, Joe the Bouncer, Harry the Cop, we present a $17 cake.
Happy Bar Mitzvah, Leonard.
Come get a new cake, you cheapskate.
All right. I didn't know she was leaving till this morning.
It's okay, it's the sentiment that counts. And Leonard and Herman and I are very thankful.
Oh, this is a present. You get the present.
Oh,
Charity Hope Valentine, we who have lived with you, undressed with you, suffered the indignities of this crummy joint with you, we who have come to know you and to love you, I'll miss you nuptially.
Are you dumb broad? Let me do that.
So, we bought this little present, which I picked out.
Oh, yeah. What the hell kind of wedding gift is that?
I thought she was pregnant. It's a
it's the best wedding gift
know, Charity, it ain't too often that one of our girls leave to marry a nice and respectable guy. In fact, this is the first time it ever happened. So, our two regular customers since 1954... ...will like a farewell dance with our soon-to-be bride, Miss Charity Valentine. Hey, Matt, this is a private party, alright?
I know, I'm here to take her away.
Oh, yeah? Hey, Charity, did you call a cab?
Oscar! This is him!
Hello.
Taking a baby away. Oscar, I'd like you to meet our boss, Kermit. So-called, the Führer.
Pleasure.
Likewise. How about a beer, Mr.
Lindquist?
Someone give Mr. Lindquist a beer.
I don't know.
Yes. Sit down. Come on, sit down. All right, everybody, I'm gonna give a speech, all right? Shut up and sit down. It's tough for a loudmouth mug like me, who all the time bellows like a bull. Take with the words about the Mrs. to be, when what you think is an empty heart is full. Tomorrow when you say I do, I'll die. I'm almost too ashamed to tell you why. I love to cry at weddings, how I love to cry at weddings. I walk into a chapel and it's happily hysterical. The ushers and attendants, the family dependents, I see them and I start to slip my through an extra handkerchief. And all through the service, while the bride and groom look nervous, tears of joy are streaming down my face. I love to cry at weddings, anybody's wedding,
anytime, anywhere, any place.
Yeah.
Hey, girl, you want a piece of candy?
Come over here, let's have a drink. You like apple pie? I make a mean apple pie.
Yeah, I got a little something.
Come over here, I got something for you. You want a tango? It takes three or four of us to tango.
Don't be shy.
What he said?
Something peaches and cream.
You walked in the joint. I could see you were a girl of distinction, a real big spender. Good looking, so refined. So wouldn't you like to know what's going on in my mind? So let me get right to the point. I don't pop my cord for every girl I see.
Strasburg. Woo! Woo!